In the previous video, you loaded sequence layers into ConnectFX and started setting up the action composite. Now that things are set up, let's start moving objects in 3D space. Double-click on the first axis node and move the gladiator over to the left of the composite. Say about minus 600 in the X position. Now select the other axis node and move the other gladiator over to the right of the composite. This time, move to about 600 in the X position. Now let's start looking at what other things you can do in the Action 3D Compositor. I'll double-click on the axis connected to the background image. With the same viewer selected, let's change the view. Go to the View menu, Action 3D Views, and look at the composite from the top view. This is mapped to the Shift 4 keyboard shortcut. Now hold Control Option and click and drag to zoom out the view. So you will see the images as well as the wireframe camera. In the Axis's Object menu, I'll push the background behind the gladiators. Now let's bend the background to create a better visual perspective. In the Surface menu, change the surface type to Extended by Cubic. We spoke about these surfaces in the Action Timeline Effects video. Click on the surface to ensure it is selected. Holding Command, I will drag a box selection over the inner tangents to select them. In the Object menu, I will switch from Surface to the Vertices menu. Adjusting the Z position slider will bend the background surface. This creates perspective when looking at the result view. To hide the black areas in the composite, we will scale up the background. Hover the cursor over the top viewer and press Escape. This will allow you to toggle between the Action Schematic viewer and the previously set viewer. Double-click on the top axis node. In the Object menu, I'll scale up the background until it fills the edge of the frame. Let's have a look at the composite from a third person's perspective. Select the result viewer, change the View menu, Action 3D Views, and select the working view. This view can be accessed as well by pressing Shift F4. This enables your working camera view to freely move around the composite. Press Option O to switch from Select mode to Orbit. You can also change the cursor mode via the Tools pull-down menu. The shape of your cursor updates, and if you click and drag on the viewer, you can now move around the 3D environment. This does not modify your actual result of your composite, since you're not moving the camera around. It just lets you look at your scene from a different perspective. Now let's go ahead and add in a few more components. First, we'll add a logo and then a layered Photoshop file. Select the Action Schematic view and press Option Escape to change the view back to the ConnectFX schematic. In the Action Controls, switch to the Media menu. Select the Action node and press Ctrl N to add a new Media Input node. You can see that the media list will be expecting some new footage. If you have hidden the Media panel, press one left arrow. In the Media panel, I will click and drag the matte container clip that came with the downloadable media. We'll explode it out to work with it. Double-click on the node to show its controls. In the Basic menu, click Explode Effects. This will reveal the fill and matte, as well as a comp node and a color frame node. All we're interested in is the fill and matte, so delete the comp node and the color frame node. I'll connect the fill to the red input of the media node. I'll also connect the alpha to the blue matte input of the media node. Remember to use the yellow output of the nodes and not the blue. Selecting the Action node, you can see the working view and the logo is part of the 3D composite. Let's place the Expos logo behind the gladiators. I'll select the working view and press F4 to see the Action result view. Also, select the ConnectFX schematic. Press Option Escape to toggle back to the Action schematic. If you don't see the nodes in the Action schematic, you can use a really handy tool for panning the schematic viewer, the Navigator. press Control Option N and the navigator will appear in the view, so you can pan around the nodes when needed. Double-click on the Axis node and in the Object menu, push the logo behind the gladiators. Next, position it just above their heads. If you scrub the time bar, you will see the gladiators move in front of the logo. I also have a layered Photoshop file that I would like to integrate into the composite. Go back to the beginning of the composite and switch to the Action Bin menu. This node bin contains all the various objects you can load into the Action 3D Compositor. It works the same way as the Connect Effects nodes that you've seen earlier. Press I over the node bin, and all the nodes labeled with I will be highlighted, including Import. Double-click on this node to go into the file browser. Change the file type to Photoshop using the pull-down menu. Using the small folder window, you can navigate to the folder where you have the PSD file. Select it, and Action will load the file. You can see the Photoshop layers already integrated into the composite. If you look at the Action schematic, you can see that all the layers are retained and connected by an axis node. I just want to draw your attention to the CFX section in the media panel. If you have the media panel hidden, press one left arrow. You can see that all the elements of the Photoshop file are stored there. All the elements, including the Photoshop layers, will be stored in this ConnectFX segment in the sequence. If you wanted to save any of the sources into a library, you just need to drag and drop the sources into a library folder. This does not move the sources from ConnectFX. It simply makes a copy for later use. Now let's get back to the composite. Use the navigator to pan over to the new nodes if you haven't already done so. The structures of the axis nodes are very important. The top node controls the group, but each layer still has its own axis to move individually. Pay close attention to the arrow on the connection between the nodes. Usually the arrow on the connection always points away from the parent to the child node. So let's move the group. Double-click on the top axis node. In the object menu, move the group in front of the gladiators. You may want to adjust the vertical position and adjust the scaling. I'll also grab the versus graphic and move that between the gladiators. So that's looking pretty good. But now I've decided that more needs to be done with the X-Ball logo. Please move on to Action Part 3 to continue your smoke getting started experience.